about the sacrifice being on the cross. It was. But right before that, when he submitted himself, when he finally overcame the flesh and submitted to that humiliation, being arrested, scourged, and then sacrificed, that was when the moment was complete. And he says, let this cup pass me. What cup was he talking about? He was talking about the cup of suffering. We need to ask ourselves a question. Do we submit to the Lord with our cup, so to speak? Whether it may be suffering, whatever it may be, submit to the Lord. Over in James chapter 4, verse 17, here James writes, therefore to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Now this is another mark of submission. Sin is contrary to what God would have us do. When the Christian does not submit to the Father and do the good as outlined in the Bible, as the Bible defines for us, they are sinning. When they are not doing what they know they should do, according to the Bible, they are not submitting. What do we submit to the Father? How do we submit to the Father in our lives? Do we submit to Him in our personal relationships? Our friends? Our spouses? Do we submit to the Lord? How about an area of money? Do we submit to the Lord? How about entertainment and recreation? Do we submit to the Lord? Another verse, Luke 17, verse 10. The Lord asked this question. So likewise ye, when you have done all those things which are commanded you, and say, we are unprofitable servants, we have done that which was our duty to do. That's submission to the Lord too. That's part of the marks of a Christian. We labor for the Master, realizing that we can never, remember this folks, never repay Him. We should never do the work for the Lord saying, well, I'm paying back the Lord some way. Because we can never do it. But we are submitting to the Lord. Our mark is to labor for Him and to submit to His authority. That's the mark of the Christian, to submit to Him. To be that unprofitable servant. The Lord was using that in that sense. So, one mark of Christian is submission. Another is humility. And to look at that, we go to a parable of the Pharisee and the publican. The publican and the Pharisee. Luke chapter 18, verse 14, where, of course, we know that both men went to the temple to pray. The publican, the Pharisee rather, looked up to God and says, oh, thank you, God, for me, basically. Look what I've done. At least I'm not like this sorry publican here. The publican smote his breast, looked down, and said, Father, forgive me, sinner. Brethren, think about it. The Lord Jesus Himself humbled Himself to come to this earth. He humbled Himself just as that. Just as the Lord says, for everyone that exalteth himself shall be abased, and humble himself shall be exalted. The Lord humbled himself.